Hey everybody, welcome back to Nico Brothers. So we're continuing building the RV, get a good look at this Vegas, because you know, basically after this, it's not going to look like a Vegas anymore. We're getting all these decals off. We're going to transform this thing and make it look brand new, because this whole faded tan color has got to go. This thing's getting reborn, so basically the front end's done, and also we're going to go around and get this whole RV looking real good. So the game plan right now is just get rid of these stickers, get rid of all the stuff that we don't need, it's in the way, and yeah, it's going to take a while, and get this thing ready, prep for paint. Let's go ahead and get it done. Wow guys, just check out the difference. This is basically where the stickers were, and this is after. This is sun-baked. It's basically that two single stage paint and clear together, what most RVs are painted with. So it lasts like that for maybe a year, but after some sun, this is what happens to basically all the RVs, and the stickers protected it. But we're gonna actually do a two stage. So we're gonna do paint, and then we're gonna do clear, how cars are painted. So hopefully it'll last longer and it won't fade out or burn out as quick. It's definitely more work and it costs more for sure, but it's gonna look good. So this doesn't happen because it's not that old. I mean, this is a 2017, 2018. And yeah, there's definitely a night and day difference. It looks like there's still stickers on there, but that is just the difference between sunbaked and not. Wow. All right, guys, so our decals have been completely taken off. I left the Vegas sign for now, but overall, I got them off. If you've never did decals before, they're kind of a pain. Honestly, go two ways. If they're really old, they become brittle. If they're sun-baked, they just rip piece by piece, and then it's a nightmare. But thankfully, these weren't that bad. They're pretty fresh, so most of them, you know, slid off pretty nicely. You could use a heat gun. I prefer the steam. There we go. Yeah. The steamer, because it doesn't burn it as bad. So basically the decals don't just disintegrate with the heat gun. It gets really hot and then it just literally melts away. With the steam, I at least have some water coming out there, so it's kind of cooling it, but it's like hot, and then it just, I don't know, it flows better. Personal preference. Honestly, you could do it either way, whatever you prefer, no big deal. But yeah, decals are off. It took a long time. It's definitely late at night, but we're still prepping to get this thing painted, and you gotta do what you gotta do. So went ahead and took the RV out of the shop. Basically, we can go ahead and clean up this area right here. Once I got all those stickers off, it's a mess. And basically, we're gonna start prepping for this place to be our paint booth. We did it before with our other RV. We just put plastic everywhere. Honestly, it's just gonna get it done this way. You know, that way we just knock it out. It's here, we're local. We know this place, all our tools are here. Be nice to get another warehouse, but it's all good. This'll work, we'll get it done. No big deal. Guys, so it's looking more and more like a paint booth. Got it covered up, so our alignment machines are doing pretty good. Got it all tarped up, it's nice and tight. Nice, but unfortunately it's like 1 a.m, so I'm basically gonna call it a night, come back in the morning, get that thing scuffed, sanded, taped, put inside, and hopefully painted. Whew, no time to waste, let's keep going. Hey, hey everybody, welcome back. It's the next morning. What a beautiful morning it is, the weather is perfect. Next thing we have to do basically is get this thing scuffed up, ready for paint. There's a lot of prep work to do on this thing because it's just so massive. So it's gonna take a while, a lot of elbow grease to get this thing nice and cleaned and ready. Cause you can still see the lines in there. We have to get rid of all those things because once you paint, you'll still see that. So we're gonna have to Scotch-Brite all that out, clean it up, get all the gunk and crannies out. And yeah, a lot of prep work. But if you want a good paint job, you gotta put in the time. So we're here, let's get it down. Let's go at it. Down, got all the dirt off, and now I have to scrub every single square inch of this thing because you know we're going pearl white with it. Color change, so it's all getting painted. Hopefully there's no debris in there, and then we're gonna scrub it, make it basically attach better to the paint. So got some Scotch-Brite, scuff stuff. Man, a lot of work, but let's do it. First section is done. You can kind of tell the difference even by how the water is going down. It just kind of sloops down over here. It actually gets stuck on that edge, and that's what I'm really Scotch-Briting off, making sure I don't have any of that like residue left or anything, because then you'll see those lines. You know what I'm talking about. So this back edge is getting there. I wanted to do it again, but do the same thing for all of it. I'll take off things, I'll take off my speakers. I don't know, we'll see. I'm debating what to do there. Oh yeah, a lot of work. This will dry up and I think you'll see a difference. Scotch-Brited and not.
this water.
One section at a time. Man, that is definitely looking better. It hasn't looked this clean in years because it's basically just scrubbing off all the dirt, all the debris, so making it uniform. Oh yeah, looking much better. Still have to do the door and more towards the face. So you could just tell the difference. I don't know if you can see all that little mold and whatever it is starting to grow on there. I'm gonna get rid of all that. Woo! What a workout. Who needs a gym? Just paint an RV. There we go, got it all prepped up. Man, that was a lot of Scotch braiding. Definitely getting sore already. Got some DA going on, some sanding. Woo, that's a lot of surface area that this RV has, so wow. But now it's time to basically drive it into our paint booth that we created and start taping. So the next series, the next step is gonna be fun too as well, because there's a lot to tape off. There's a lot of things, a lot of crevices, a lot of things we don't want paint on there. So yeah, let's get it out of the sun, get it inside the shop. Make sure all the water's gone, blow it off, and tape it up. We'll be right back. lot of taping from the awning to all the trim, to the windows, to the side, to the anything that we don't want white is covered up. I mean, basically we're getting there, but there's still a very important step ahead of us. We need to tack cloth it, we need to wipe it down, wax and grease remover, all our fingerprints, you know, touching it. I know we already washed it, but still handling it like that. So we definitely need to wipe it down so our paint sticks to it, no reactions, nothing like that. So yeah, now we have all this square footage that we have to go ahead and clean real quick. And then finally be time for base.
Sealer.
And then the paint, and then the pearl, and then the clear. Wow, definitely been another long night, but yeah, let's go ahead and wipe it down. There we go, guys. Man, it's looking great, looking really clean, just a pearl white and black accent. I think there's definitely enough going on without the stripes, honestly. Even the Vegas sign looks awesome. I even basically put a new fresh clear coat on there and brought it back to life. Wow, that looks amazing. Honestly, it looks great. All right, guys, so it's the next day because it's already past midnight again. This is like the second, third day in a row. I don't know, it's all mixing in together. A lot of long days, long nights and weekends, but that's what we do, Nico Bros, to get it out. Man, we are exhausted for sure. That was definitely a huge project, but man, I can't wait to see this thing with the face on and driving down into the sunset. It's gonna look magical for sure. But that's all that's happening tonight, guys. Thanks so much for watching. Make sure you stay tuned. We are gonna get this thing going eventually, but hey, still beautiful progress. It's motivating to even keep going further, put it back together, final assembly, and we'll finally change those batteries out. So no more chirping at the fire alarm detector thing. Honestly, I don't even hear it anymore, but you know, you guys are writing comments and we hear you. We understand. Next time. After this, that'll be our first thing to do by putting it together while getting new batteries. Or just remove them. Thanks, guys. Catch you next time.